Welcome to another episode of Behind the Science on Location. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. If someone told me that there were nano-sized additives in my food, I would think they were talking about a sci-fi movie. Well, this is not a movie, folks. Nano-sized food additives are found in many food products. The research of its health impact is limited, and the FDA standard level is doubted to be low enough. So in this episode of Behind the Science, let's take a trip to a lab at the University of Massachusetts Amherst to see just how they are testing the interaction of nano-sized food additives with some components in our digestive system. Oh, I'm so glad I found you.
Oh, hi, welcome to UMass.
Thank you. So I was in the hallway and I was reading some of the posters and I came across one of your posters on nanoparticles and it made me start to think, and I was looking at the gum that I had in my purse and I noticed that in the ingredient list there was titanium dioxide. Why do they add these things to our food?
Titanium dioxide is used as a whitening agent in our food products like chewing gum, donuts, because in the icings, and also in our toothpaste.
Wow, and all these products. So one thing that you mentioned though was nanoparticles. What are nanoparticles?
Nanoparticles are extremely small sized particles because they are so small that they may be absorbed through our digestive tract and interact with our liver tissues and organs.
Oh, I can see that being a problem.
Yes.
Yeah, so is it just titanium dioxide or are these other nanoparticles that are in our food?
Well, there are different types of nanoparticles. For example, silver nanoparticles and zinc oxide nanoparticles. They are used as anti-bacterial agents in our food package. And they can also migrate into our food. And also we have silica nanoparticles, which is as an anti-caking agent in the powdery food. Yes, we are getting exposed to nanoparticles every day throughout our whole life.
Right, and I mean, I work at water, so I'm very familiar with silica and titanium dioxide, and we have some of those in our products, but I don't know if I want them in the food that I eat. So what are the effects of having these in our food?
Well, we have done some animal studies to determine the potential adverse effects of these nanoparticles. Let me show you the details on the whiteboard.
Sounds good.
Let's go. What we found is size really matters. Nanoparticles caused liver injury and kidney injury, induced inflammation in mice, and also disrupt the bacterial community harbored in the digestive tract. And smaller sized particles has stronger adverse effects.
So my guess is that we're not gonna change manufacturing overnight. So what can we do to minimize the toxicity of these things?
Good question. And I have a good news. In our lab, we found a specific compound that can bind with those nanoparticles and minimize the adverse effects. Let's go back to the whiteboard. I will show you the details.
Let's take a look.
Flavonoids with ortho hydroxyl group can bind titanium dioxide nanoparticles, and this interaction led an aggregation of the nanoparticles, potentially resulting in lower absorption and lower toxicity. We can find those flavonoids in fruit and vegetables like apples, berries, tea leaves, etc.
Well, next time I chew gum or brush my teeth, I'm gonna think of your research.
A little tip, after you chew gum, probably you can drink a cup of tea or juice.
Just to be safe, let's go drink some tea now.
Let's go.
I can tell you from now on, I will be reading my food labels with a different perspective, looking for those nanoparticles. And just to be safe, consuming more flavonoids just in case. If you would like to learn more about this work, check out the peer-reviewed paper you can access at the link below. And join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science on Location.